Okay, dear students, I welcome you for the fourth part of our lesson, What is God? Through previous three videos, we have discussed what is meant by government, then we have discussed functions of government, then levels of government, then in third part, we have discussed about universal adult franchise, and then women's suffrage movement, and at last we have discussed about features of democratic government. Today we will be discussing the exercise and NCERT solutions for the same lesson. So there are textbook questions that we will be discussing today. Okay, so let's begin. The first question of your textbook is, what do you understand by the word government? And list five ways in which you think the government affects our daily life. So, this is exercise that we will be discussing. Okay, so answer of this question first we'll see about what is mean by the word government. So government is the mechanism or group which govern and implement decision in an organized manner formed under certain written rules. So what is government? Government is a group of people. There are certain group of people, they come together and form a government, and they can take certain decisions, and that decisions are regarding the citizens of the country. Okay, so they have certain rights to rule the country. The next sub question of this list, five ways in which you think government affect our daily life. So here are certain ways where the government is affecting our day-to-day life, daily life. First, it protects the boundaries of the country and maintains peaceful relations with other countries. So what the government does, they protect the boundaries of the country. Like we have the neighboring countries, like we have China, we have Pakistan, and other countries. So what is the function of the government? The function of the government is to protect the boundaries of that particular country. So this is the way how they can affect our life. Second, it takes action on many social issues. There are certain social problems that government tries to solve, like poverty is there, or other issues that government try to solve and try to find out solutions. Then it ensures welfare of citizens and provide health facility. So government provide us health facilities like we have hospitals, then medicines and different health facilities are provided by the government. It ensures the supply of food and drinking water to its people. So people are given the drinking water, they are provided drinking water also, and they are provided food. Okay. So it helps in running of postal and railway services. We have postal system that we have already discussed. Then there are other things like postal system is there, then they have railway system. We have railways. These are the some functions that how the government is affecting. Next question. Next question is, what do you think the government need to make rules? Why do you think the government need to make the rules for everyone in the form of laws? So this question's answer we'll be discussing. Government need to make rules for everyone in the form of laws because it helps in preventing the authority from misuse of the power. If the rules are made, the authorities or the powerful people will not use or misuse the power. So this is one way we can control on the government. It helps in the functionings of the government. It will help for the better functioning of the government if the people are given rights, if the people are given in the form of making laws or they are involved. Okay. Next, it helps in functioning of the government. I told you, it helps the people in leading their normal and peaceful life. Okay. So if the people, if the government is making the rules, if the government is making laws, it will help. It will help for what? Leading the life peacefully. People can live a peaceful life if the rules are made. For example, traffic rules. If the traffic rules are not made, there are chances that there may be accidents. So the rules are important for the betterment of the people or to lead a normal and peaceful life of the people. Then it ensures the security of the nation. If the rules are made and people are following, if there are chances that the country will be safer, it will be more safe. So it is beneficial for the safety of the people, security of the people. Next. Next question is, we'll be discussing the next question. The next question is, so what are the features of democratic government is the next question. So there are two essential features of a democratic government. We have discussed in our previous video. So people have the right to elect their own government through elections. In democratic country, there are elections taken place after, in our country, we have elections after each 5 years. So after each interval, the people have the right to vote and select their representative. So people have the right to choose their government. So they are participating in electing the government. The next one is, government is accountable to its people. Accountable means, people can ask why you have taken such decisions. People can oppose the decisions of the country, or they can share their views regarding decisions taken by the government. So it is accountable, means they have to answer. It is answerable. So government is answerable. People can ask to government, and government has to answer to people that why you have taken these decisions, or they are responsible. Next one is universal adult franchise. Universal adult franchise, I have already told you, those who have completed their age, particular age of getting rights, like in our country India, we have the age criteria of 18 years. Whoever is completing 18 years of age, it may be a male, it may be female, it may be Hindu, it may be Muslim, or any caste, any religion, any color. So he will get a right, that is universal adult franchise. So in a democratic country, this is one of the important feature. Universal adult franchise means every citizen is getting the right of vote. Next question, or next question is, what was the suffrage movement? What did it accomplish? So I have discussed with you. Meaning of the word suffrage means right to vote. Meaning of the word is right to vote. Women and poor have to fight for participation in government all over Europe and USA. In country, I have told you, like in Europe country, European continent and USA, people, especially the women and the poor people, demanded for the right of vote. They also wanted to participate in the government. So they came on the roads, they had strikes, they opposed the government and demanded that we should have right of voting. Especially women came together and they formed association, they came form groups, and they demanded government to give the right of voting. That right, from that moment, is known as suffrage movement. During first war, it got strengthened. After first war, It got strengthened, means it became more powerful after the First World War. And this movement is known as women's suffrage movement. And what were the what it could accomplish, what it could get? It gave right to vote to the America women in 1920. In America, American women got the right in 1920, and women in United Kingdom, they also got the right of vote in the year 1928. This is the accomplishment, or this is the result of this movement. Means in these two countries, women also got the right of voting. In America, it got 1920, and United Kingdom it got 1928. This movement is women's suffrage movement. Okay, the next question and the last question of our discussion is, so Gandhiji strongly believed that every child, every adult in India should be given the right to vote. However, a few people don't share his view. They feel the illiterate people who are mainly poor should not be given right to vote. What do you think? Do you think this would be a form of discrimination? Give 5 points to support your view and share this with class. This is the question. Gandhiji demanded that every adult or who has completed 18 years of age, rather that time it was 21. Afterwards, government has reduced the age of voting, and it has now it is 18 years. That time, Gandhiji demanded that every adult should get the right of vote. But people, some of the people were opposing Gandhiji. They were saying that the poor people should not be given the right, or illiterate people should not be given the right of voting. So the question is, what is your opinion about this? Of course, these also people have the right of voting, they should also get the right. Means poor people should get the right, and the demand of Gandhiji was very right. Okay, the people who belong to poor community and who are poor, they also should get the right to vote. And even illiterate people also should get, illiterate means those who are not educated, they also should get the right of voting. There are certain points to, and this is a discrimination. This is difference, making difference, and discriminated people, poor, rich, so this should not happen. These people will not able to participate in the government. What will happen? It would be form of discrimination, and if you, to support this point, we have certain points. The people will not be able to participate in the government if they are neglected, if they are not given the right to vote, they will not be part of the government, so this is not good one. So they should be part of government because they are citizens. Okay, next, people form all classes fought for the independence, and these rights thus everyone should treat it equally. For the independence, you know that independence movement was taken place, and Indian people demanded independence from the Britishers. That time every citizen has participated. It may be poor, it may be rich, it may be women, it may be men, everybody. Everybody demanded the right, everyone was asking, and they supported for the getting freedom. So people, they have taken efforts for the getting independence. So everyone has the right to get voting. So next one, people are not illiterate or poor by their choice. Those people who are poor, or they are illiterate, rather poor we can say. If the people are poor, so it is not their fault. So they are also human beings. Though they are poor, but they are human beings. They also have the rights. They should be also given equal chances. So it is not good to discriminate because of they are poor or they are illiterate. They are not educated. Okay. So these are the some of the points that regarding. Next. One more point that we can add in this, every adult should be given right to vote according to universal adult franchise. We have discussed about this. It will affect the idea of right of equality of democracy. If the people are not given the right to vote, there will not be equality. there will not be any equality, and that is against the law of democracy. It will not be possible if their people are discriminated. There won't be any successful democracy if the people are discriminated. They are given the unequal treatment. Okay, these are the discussion. This was the discussion about textbook question. So all you, I have given certain sample. This is not the final one. You can write your own answers. I have just given a sample. Don't copy it as it is. You can write your own answers. Whatever answer I have told, these are the general answers. So you can write by your own, and it is expected from you, people in the 6th standard, that you should write your own answers. Okay, so this is one sample only. You should not be much dependent on these answers only. If the answers are not visible, let it be. You should try to solve your own way. So it will be helpful to you in the final exam also. Okay, I hope you must have understood, and we have discussed the lesson thoroughly with 4-5 videos, and go through those videos again and again. And if you have any doubts, you can ask. You can send an email, and you can contact on my mobile number. Thank you. Take care.